Educator, lawyer, civil rights activist, public servant, statesman, trailblazer. All are words that could describe Leroy Reginald Johnson, Jr. Born in Atlanta on July 28, 1928, Johnson attended Booker T. Washington High School before earning his bachelor's degree from Morehouse College and his master's degree from Atlanta University. Johnson would teach in the Atlanta public school system before earning a law degree. Then he would make history. The year was 1957, and Leroy Johnson broke a barrier when he was hired by the Fulton County Solicitor General's office to work as a criminal investigator, the first African American to do so. In 1960, Johnson answered the call to become a civil rights activist, serving as an advisor to black college students who were staging sit-ins at downtown Atlanta lunch counters. In 1962, Leroy Johnson sought a seat in the Georgia State Legislature and became the first African American elected to the state Senate since 1907. Johnson's historic election would break down barriers within the state Capitol building as his presence brought the end of segregated restrooms, water fountains, and the cafeteria. Johnson would prove to be an influential force in state government, serving as the chairman of the powerful Senate Judiciary Committee. Leroy Johnson will perhaps best be remembered for his role in staging Muhammad Ali's return to the ring after the former champion was forced out of boxing for his opposition to the Vietnam War. On October 26, 1970, the bout between Ali and Jerry Quarry brought national media attention to the state of Georgia and the city of Atlanta. Johnson would leave the Senate in 1975 after serving 12 years, but remained highly regarded as an early supporter of MARTA and serving as the executive director of the Atlanta Fulton County Recreation Authority. Johnson was honored with a portrait that hangs in the state Capitol building, and a portion of Fulton Industrial Boulevard bears his name. Atlanta Mayor Keisha Lance Bottoms remembered Johnson this way: "Senator Leroy Johnson and his beautiful family have long represented the very best aspects of Atlanta. As the first African American elected to the state legislature in more than 50 years, Senator Johnson was a groundbreaking statesman whose formidable presence in the Georgia Senate 2 years before the signing of the Voting Rights Act put equality into play in Southern politics. Our entire city mourns the passing of this Atlanta legend, and we extend our deepest sympathies to his family and friends." Leroy Johnson was 91 years old.